Hey. Welcome back. More bolt gun. Let's see if I can finish up chapter 2. I'm not really sure how much I have left of it. And I'm assuming there's at least one more chapter. 2 chapters seems like too few. Just call it halves or something, but there'll be at least 3 chapters, so we'll see how far we get today. Hope you enjoyed the earlier ones if you've seen them. Alright, should be able to just continue here. Just checking my settings again. Alright. Oh. Mash V while using your chainsaw. Ah. You learn new things every day. Oh, that's right. That's where I was up to. Alright. Just 1 second. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that. Now, let's see if I can actually do this, unlike last stream, where I was getting major combat fatigue. Alright, so shotgun, plasma, yep, okay. Just make those. That's fine. This time I'm gonna start because they're not doing checkpoints for me. I'm gonna do some little save points. I'll check in a minute if there's a save point. Okay, let's check to see if there's that quick save button. Alright, controls, customize, quick save, there is. F6. Okay, that'll work. Because we just can't be reloading. Thank you. some of these dudes out. Pretty sure this is the guy that killed me last time. Okay, alright. So we're getting somewhere. So it's all new from here on out. Okay, there's a way that way. There's a way that way. Oh, I guess we're going this way first. Works for me. You say so? Anything around here? No. Okay, so there's no way to go back, so that's... We're pushing on. Reminder if I come back to play this again in the future. But I'll have to try the left side over there. Oh, this is bad news. Time to use grenades because those things suck. Shotguns do SFA against them. Sounds like just a plant. Don't know whether I should be really using this here, but feels like we're coming up against a lot of stronger targets now. Big guns, so I will go back to heavy bolter. Save barrels to save ammo. It's the best thing about this heavy bolter is that there's no reload at all, as far as I. You can never carry more ammunition than the magazine will take, so you can literally fire all the ammunition you have. We'll save a little bit of heavy bolter ammo there. Throw another save down here. I'll try not to make that too frustrating with pauses and such, but. Maybe I'll make up for it by not backtracking as much as I was earlier, because it seems to be more just pushing on. This guy's not even going to fire back, that certainly makes life easier for me. We're going up there, and this may be the end of the mission. Vault location reached. Archiving success. All ammo crate? Hells yeah. Let's reload these things. Alright, let's push on. Using teal energy. Earlier in the game. I suppose there's no reason not to use my bigger guns here until I run out of. You've got everything here. Well, the Nurgle enemies, anyway. Thankfully, they don't seem to combine the Zinch enemies and the Nurgle enemies together. Good job. fairly frustrating, I think, so that's a good choice. It's just hitting the shield there, that looks like things. Yeah, I need to find some more health somewhere. That will do. There's a dog. He's headed me off. I'm unlearning. Now that there's more guns being added, you don't fight a certain enemy for a while, and it's easy to forget which ones do the trick, which ones don't. I feel like the melter is just appropriate for... Oh, no, I'm gonna die. The maestas. All the health it's gonna give me. I'm gonna have 2 hit points here. He's only at half health. Ah. It's gonna take some work. Don't pick anything up until you need it. Toe, apparently that was enough. The plasma gun. I sort of didn't appreciate earlier the splash damage that you get out of this, because there's not a whole lot of stuff in this game that does splash damage. I just need to focus on the... It's hard to track down some things though. Looks like I'm just circle straightening the end of that. Which is nice. Seems like an easy way to deal with those. So this one just like rail guns me. Right there. Right, so maybe this can do with a play toad for me. I hate these things. Seems like a waste, but they're just such a pain. Okay, I shouldn't have wasted that. That was a bad pickup. Okay, we go to double ammo. I'll better do that. The saucer was really low health, and I'm not really sure what I did to do that much damage to him. I'm wondering if killing the adds damaged him. or I just did more than I expected. I put that the special grenade down, and it, I think it hit him. Maybe that was it. That seemed really effective. Definitely my lowest percentage of kills compared to the earlier missions, and they're certainly getting harder. So guess that's the way it's supposed to be. Vortex grenade tears a hole between real space and the warp. Right, well, I mean, if that's what did that damage, which I think it is, then very effective against bosses. Hold on to them if you can. So I am now in chapter 3. So let's reset all the weapons again. Sorcery and redacted presence identified. Ground security at risk. Traitor, psycho, something. Stuff up here. Oh, I got the shotgun already. So that's a lot earlier. Grenade up there. Honestly, I don't know why I didn't figure that earlier, just to use the melee to teleport to them. But obviously that's the way to go. Game design tool to use weak enemies like that to show you sort of where you want to go. Put the arrows there as well. Appreciated. Thank you. Okay, but oh. Oh, I haven't seen one of these heavy bolter already. So yeah, no mucking around in chapter 3. Straight to some powerful weapons, which is nice. Not having to just use the base bolter for long periods of time like we did in the first couple of chapters. Probably shouldn't have just stood there and let them do that to me, but you know. Yeah, that V button for the additional chainsword stabs is really not the way I'd want to play. Controls, customize. A bit weird that I'm working this out now when it's been a mechanic since the start, but. Oh, it looks like you can just tap right mouse. Okay. So forget that. Do the teleport thing to them. Well, not teleport. Do the charge thing. And then just keep hitting right click. You don't need to worry about feet. Even though the thing says so. Well, at least that's how it looks. I'll try against an enemy that actually has enough hit points to take a couple of slashes. So looks like you can continue to do that, but you don't have any sort of immunity from damage, so... Wow. It's like a whole thing now. Look at this. Have I used one like this? I guess I have. Okay. Is that an aspirin as well? It's cool. I really don't want to get trapped in there. Hey. Good lord. Oh my word. I'm throwing a grenade up at me. Keep the silence up. Oh. Actual madness. Oh, I thought the jump up to chapter 2 was big. This is a whole nother thing. Something janked out there, that was weird. I got the Volkite already. It looks like that's the way I'm supposed to go, so we'll go back to trying to do that. It's possible the game is now supposed to be... you don't stay and fight every battle, and that you're supposed to sort of wade your way through, but I'm not sure at all. That doesn't feel right for this game. It feels like you're supposed to be able to sort of crush everything you want to crush, but if that's the case, then we'll just take it as it comes. Lots of ammo around. More of these things that I don't really understand. Did I just spawn Chaos Space Marines on myself? A bit rough, that's the case, but oh, whatever. If that's what I did, then that's what I did. Maybe it spawned them early so I don't have to fight them with another wave, or who knows. I don't keep. Oh, I think I just opened the door for the key there, so worth if that's the case. Came this way. Apologies for backtracking. Don't have a whole lot of ammo for that. This one I'll try and keep if I get outnumbered or... Alright. Entrance located. Position above. Yeah. Servitor chooses very strange times to come out and try and help me. Oh, I was doing a lot of that. That took way too much damage there. I wonder if I should have thrown down a quick save. I'll do one now, just in case, Oh, sorry, I couldn't see my crosshair. I prefer not to go back to the very start of the session, if I can avoid it. They track a little bit. I've noticed that up to now. I'm sure it's not new. Probably explains why I was getting hit by some of them earlier. Oh, you cheat. Oh, stuff myself here with health, but a quick save and move on. Should be enough health to deal with it. Using the quick save so much now, I put the down keybind on my mouse. But it's not because I'm, you know, I'm finding the challenge too difficult to be fun. It's just simply that the checkpoints aren't as frequent as it feels they need to be for my taste. So, it's good to have the feature for you, because it means if you want to use them, they're there, and if you don't, you don't have them. It's fine. Would you look at these guys? Oh, they go from aspirants to chosen. Stupid enough to let them get back up. Save. No, I know also. You can probably just use the standard bolter, right? When you get the what is effectively quad damage, I think. Harder to see the grenade markers on the ground when you got this mode going on. I feel like the longer this chapter goes on, the less of those helpful little health pickup boxes I'm going to find around the place. This is an exalted fire. Area successfully burned. Okay. Concentration base, right? Back that stuff up. Now, work out where I'm supposed to go after all that madness. Right, so, this is nothing. This is nothing. I'm supposed to go up there. Bolts your ammo. No grenades if I need them, I do not. Oh! That's a very tight little mission. I wonder if these stages in chapter 3 are going to be those high intensity shorter stages. We'll see. Looks like secrets are harder to find, for sure. Okay. Oh, know your stuff. Two steps out of the front door. Oh, now we're doing frog stuff. Just frog beaters. Look at them all. I'm enjoying the environment a lot more here in the sort of forge in the city. The as opposed to those really quite bland environments in number two, caves and such. But, you know, I understand variety is better than not variety, so, you know, maybe I'd be saying different if the whole game was like this, so I can appreciate that too. This way, right? Oh, there's a big floor there. I don't know whether that's worth using my grenades on that, but disgraceful. State of this. Oh no! Oh, my God. I got nibbled by a Nurgling. Alright. Probably should have learned that from the first time around, but I didn't realize I was right at the start again. Oh, that's right, those blisters they leave on the ground pop. It's interesting, if you jump and then hit the shift key, you accelerate as if you're sprinting. Jump. A little confusing, but it's quite fun, so I didn't change it there. This again. This time I'm going to go up. Okay, no, I'm not. Quick save, starters, and then I'm going to go up. Well, I'm going to hit a heavy bolt right. See if I can just delete this side. Oh, that's really good up in place. Big dude dealt with. Quick save. And then moving. Still don't know what this does, but moving down here. Obviously you don't have to kill everything, but they're going to give me a percentage at the end of every stage of how many of them I kill. I'm going to try and kill them all, because it feels undoable. Oh my God, this feels like another purge area, doesn't it? Rav cannon. BFG. Really not gonna give me any health. This is real rough. Mm-hmm. such low health. Oh, and it was plasma gun. Huh. Oh, this is gonna be hard. This quick save point. So, pull out the big gun. Jeez, I can barely see. Couldn't move the tongue. Okay. Oh, this feels like a trap. Jeez. Just the way they can pre-fire you. And you got me with the plasma gun again. Just because they track you so accurately. Oh no! Oh! There's no point fighting on with this one, is there? No. I played too. Alright, what guns do I have? I'm just too low health to start with. Maybe if I go out with the Boltgun. Super low. Look at the ball card. I don't think that was any better. I'm sure I just damaged myself a lot there. No! Alright, I think I was getting close there. They don't spawn exactly how they did. Oh man. You really have to pick the damaging targets out, but the problem is that in this scenery, it is incredibly difficult to see. I didn't get anywhere with that, did I? What hit me so hard? If you stand still and they can't kill you. Oh, I had the shield. That's weird. Okay, so I'm on... the plasma guy. The plasma guy hits you straight away. You are bold. Look at that. He just leads you so expertly. Which is crazy, because it's just like... damage the big one. Are we gonna keep throwing things in on me? I don't think I can do this. I don't think I can do this with what I've got. I mean, I'm sure somebody... Oh, can I just cheese it like this? Is that something I can do? That doesn't seem in the spirit of... trying to do here, but I don't know whether this is actually going to improve my situation, but the stuff just spawns right in on you. So, look, I'm supposed to deal with that. Kudos for giving me the big guns, but oh my god. It opened the door for me, but I don't know how much that helps me. Gee, if any of it bothered giving me, those plasma rifle dudes. Oh my! Looks as though we've just done it. Sorry, I didn't have time to try and eat out any of that. Not that I've been doing a great job at eating out the nonsense the server has been saying. But, yeah, quick save? For sure, after that one. Okay, so that's the Boltgun one. Let's have a look at this one. Okay, reminder that's there if I need to come back for it. Let's wrap another save. Let's get moving. Its own save here for me. Okay, like red on red in some of these areas. Supply. Oh. That was just stupid. Throwing that frag grenade there. I thought it was a frag grenade. Wasted a bunch of my content there, which I can't pick up because it was boosted up by the that moral or whatever you call it, the Roman style wreath crown. Seem like those Terminator ones get jammed, sort of not fighting back sometimes. Just letting myself get a lot there, playing around with the tank. I don't know why he's calling a frog a renegade, but I feel like he might have been talking the Militar. Okay. Servitor, can you give me any tips now? No? Fair enough. Don't want to stand on that, please. Got a jump. Doesn't look like there's enough of a lip on there to walk on. At least it's a little lull in combat for us. Oh, there we go. See? Seem to be getting all those regular bolter upgrades. I was getting in the earlier missions as well to make that regular bolter more fun to use. So that's forcing me to sort of use the arsenal of guns more. Oh! Thankfully, that didn't injure me. That was silly. Now he's shooting back. There, if I need it, I'll jump back down. No more of that gun for the roll while I get some more ammo. Isn't that weird? Apparently I wasn't quite close enough to pick that up. I didn't even have the plasma gun for ammo, so that would have been a nice scratch just to drop that in there. Slow loop over my shot, perfectly dodging it. Whatever. I don't know whether I want to go down there. Maybe in a bit. Like it's going somewhere exciting. Third room, maybe. It is not advised to remain in a Promethean overflow chamber. We are currently in a Promethean overflow chamber. Yeah, okay. Sound advice. Oh, right. Yeah, this is. Jammed on something that's really good. Just keep moving up. That heavy bolt around there while I can. Okay. Didn't even kill it. You gotta go. And they still take a little bit of a beat. Just lots of hit points, I think. Gave me the yellow marker for that one, but okay, you've come this far, we're not going to do that to you. Going up. Yeah. Chamber has reached Promethean acid. Alright. It's not easy. It's not easy. I'm sure there's plenty of people who play this, you know, on high difficulties and stuff, and they're like, oh, I've been playing Boomer Shooters non-stop since 1997. And, power to those people. Good on them. Guys and gals of that persuasion. I respect that. Okay, yellow key and red key. Yeah. Yep. Tight little corridors. Found the red key. That is good news. All the little military guys here today, but one Chaos Space Marine. Okay, just gonna check up here quickly. Okay, I need a purple key there. Is that anything? Kinda look like it might be a secret. That's where I came from, so we're on this way. I don't know why F5 is quick save in like every game. Except for this one. F6, which is fine. Just takes me that extra one second to find it. Which is probably okay because you don't want to quick save somewhere where you're totally bugged, like I was in that area. They're not totally bugged. Make it real tough for yourself. So that's probably why they moved it, so you, I think, just 1 second longer to make sure you actually want to stick your knife away. Just appreciate it. Or whatever, I just like F6. That's it. I'm gonna shoot him in. You want that grab ammo for sure. Grab the grab. A trap. Shoddy boys. Alright, continuing to go up. Ah, now I got the Vengeance Launcher. So that's good. I do find this useful from time to time. So now, we will use the red door. Inch enemies, maybe? That's what that sounds like. Just standard bolter for this stuff. I don't know why I'm doing that to myself. Wasting my bolt cards full, so apparently should use that. Oh, purple kit. Whatever. It's doing the job still. Are they going to be a little Volkrad on my own anyway? Very nice of them. I appreciate it. Grab ammo. Apparently I missed that earlier. Alright, going back now to get that purple floor. Oh! Boost bombs. Well, not boost bombs. Use bombs. So what did I do? I came up here and I went through the little throw doors. Flip on dudes. And I drop down a hole and the purple door was here. No? Two here? Yeah, up here. And there was a dude there and I killed him. Okay. Yeah, it's time for purple door. Choice for for Terminators. For guns, I kept switching back to the wrong ones. Those blue ones literally take one shot, and it just shows you how much I'm missing if I look for that one. I used to grenade them way back in the day to stop more blue guys. Well, that's good news. Shooting this does pretty good against it. Okay, I'm just gonna throw myself a quick save here. Oh, that is good news. Okay. No. What else have I got? No, I'm so dead. Oh, okay. Apologies for the very strange sort of panic noises coming out of my mouth at the moment, but so it's just pure panic. Grab one ship. But what I need is health. I don't really care how low his health is at the moment. because you can one-shot me with that big movie that's... Okay, there we go. Where are you, Skaters? Wow, that was... You didn't know a whole lot of... Those haven't got easy. I don't know how many of them fought in the campaign of those now. I believe it's four. There was one in chapter one. And at least two in chapter two. And then that one there. So, I believe that's the fourth one. But, who knows? Okay, so I did get the key, though, which means, if I can, now that I can regather my thoughts again, it means I can go back, but I don't know where I came from now, so. Just gonna have to search around, my apologies. Did I come down here? I have a purple key, but that's shut. Does that mean that it's shut behind me? Because I'm pretty sure that's how I came in. But that's fine, if they're sending me a different way. In presence of Power Temple, glory to the machine, go glory to the... Okay. Oh, this just opened. This is the exit door. I did see that have one of those glowing red, you can't come through here until you're done purging things on it. Oh, we're back in the main. Cauldron smelt stone antone for planetary battery shells. Request avoid interference with the smelter. No promises. That sounds like, yeah, genuinely request? All, like, some ammo for all guns, but it doesn't... Earlier, I think I said on stream that it gives you full ammo for all guns, but I don't believe it does. Which is fine. So there it is. Oh, yeah. I forgot I had the Vengeance Lodger. Maybe that... Somebody that would have helped me. Memorial to Elevator Construction Staff. Registering names and full. Well, thank you for building us an elevator. I do appreciate it. Is that what this... Oh. I don't know how I didn't see that before. Anyway. I wouldn't have got the joke about the elevator stuff. Oh, this looks like it's going to be a fight. Time, dudes. I think I should just be less worried about that. Use up ammo, change your weapon. Don't stress too much about it. End of the mission anyway. That was a good one. That's the best one since chapter one, I think, that mission. Elevator. You made your way out of the bowels of the crown. You. Enter the grand elevator, find the controls and ascend. Beware, it seems the heretics have already hitched a ride. Oh yeah. Wow. Uh-oh. Thank you. need to set up a mute button. That kind of thing. Apologies. Just seeing if there's any ammo or any... Well, that's unpleasant. They're like, yeah, jump down in the hole. Fine, let's do it. Even better than I expected. This isn't anything. I don't know where to go. Somewhere. All right, let's have a think. Hello? Aha. Is this anything? Well, I mean, I'm up here now. I'm not sure. That guy just wait it out. Just starve to death. It's preferable. Oh. No! He was mooning me. It made me fall. It's either a secret or it's where you're supposed to go. I don't mind that either. Saying I didn't get these in the later missions, I was only getting them in the earlier ones. And I do like having these special bolt gun rounds. Wow, this is making me feel stupid because it's just a normal room. There's no like puzzle here. I just can't see where to go. Give me a moment. I'm going to find where to go, and then I'm going to take a couple of minutes break, because apparently my brain stopped. Aha. Okay. Airlock. Alright, I'm going to take a short break. I'll be right back. Okay. Back to it. Apologies for the wait there. Just needed to look at something else for a minute there. See if I can reboot my brain a touch. Well, that's right, I've got the special ammo. Huge room. Yeah, wow. Easy to get lost in spaces like this, but it feels like a real space, you know? Whereas so many spaces, especially in older shooters, don't feel like real places. I mean, some gross Nurgle pit. Not, you know, this isn't super obvious what's going on here, but it feels enough like a factory floor or something like that. Doesn't feel like just designed purely for gameplay purposes. Although, you know, just a giant cavernous space. No idea where to go, though. Let's try and head up. Whoa! Lose control of my movement. Just gonna keep going up. I'm assuming I'm gonna have to fight something in here. It's too big of an arena to not. Okay. Another guy camped out here. Alright. I was down there and I looked up here and now I'm up here and I'm looking down there. Can I make this? Why not? Woo! Special grenade for the inevitable boss battle. Okay. There's a room with lasers. Lots of health and stuff around. It's going to be a massive battle if it happens. Crazy not going to fight in here though, right? But some. Feels like they're just letting you explore around, learn the area a little bit. And then they're going to even grab cannon ammo. That's what I'm talking about. More help. So I went up to the very top. Now I've gone down to the bottom. I don't know why I'm trying to pick up ammunition. I clearly have just about everything except for grab cannon, which is wonderful. I just found some more. Pretty much full on that for whatever comes next. Of question is, what does come next? Where do I go? See if we can find some gameplay markers. So the purple door that I can't open, there's purple things over here. Is that leading me to something? Do I shoot them? I do not. Nearly fell down. I just want to be clear that the controls and the movement aren't, like, bad or anything in this. I'm just a doofus. So, sometimes, I'm going to fall off things. I don't know why I'd go up there. There doesn't seem to be any reason to go up there, but I just need to continue exploring, I suppose. I'm trying to find something that will either trigger a fight or move me on to another area. I mean, I can happily jump over onto there, but there doesn't seem to be any reason to do that. Should I climb back up there? Maybe there's something over here like this. The Nurgle Pit certainly stands out. But I'm not sure whether it is anything gross. Okay, now I'm up here. I can't remember if I came up here before. Yes, I did. So I did. So what do we do? Controls located. Engage transit ritual. Communicate. Excitement. Yep, found the red. So, presumably if I trigger this, it's going to be a fight. Yeah. Here we go. I've chosen to use the vengeance energy here, but that's what's happening. Effective against him. I knew if I turned around there'd be one. I just knew it. Oh. trigger the presence reduce. Search for to acquire. Okay. So first one done. Melter. Okay, interesting. So that means that this wasn't previously open. I suppose. Came up here. Can't even remember. Ah, yes. So, I need to find the purple key now. So, presumably. That's just kicking around somewhere. Oh. What do you say? It's through the purple door. This is where I came in. I think so. Where's the key hide? Just gonna keep using the Volkite gun for now. I guess I came through there. I may as well just kill this guy. Seems crazy not to, right? Can't leave him alive. Contents secretus. Great. Lovely. So I don't know if this is going to have enemies in it again straight away, or not until I fire up the, so use the heavy bolter for this section. So Volcarite ammo. So easy to get massively turned around in here because it's just such a enormous area, which is cool because it's totally different to any game space in this game up until this point. So I'm going to go with the gold fight until I use that up, just because I like the gun so much. And I see no reason to make it harder for myself. Fall off. No space marines yet, but they will come. Something will come. Plasma guys. Let him hit you. You're in trouble. Honestly, even though they die in more or less one shot, they are tougher than some of the bigger enemies that are simply bullet sinks. So there. Just throw another one down there. Still another key to place. Oh, purge finished. I wonder how many of them accidentally kill themselves. Sort of falling off things trying to get to me. Search new floor. So that's the yellow door, so the purple door should be open now. A little bit more Volkite ammo, which is nice. So now we need to find the door to get to the yellow key's location, and then I'll be able to go through this door. Oh, so the heavy bolter got the upgrade there, so I'll keep that in mind. I'm still not 100% sure. It's the bench. Sorry, I thought that was heavy bolter ammo. Still not 100% sure what the upgrades do, but I'm presuming extra damage or I think the bolter, the regular bolter, it might actually give you a larger magazine, but obviously that's not the case in the heavy bolter because it doesn't have a magazine. Excuse me, sorry. Yellow thing is yellow. Oh. Well, that wasn't hard. Just look for what you're seeking, you shall find. Oh. Attention, beware, escape xenofauna. Well, are you going to throw new enemies at me at this point in the game? Yeah. I've killed a lot of these dudes. Oh, sandals? I forgot we had ambles in this game. It's been a while since I fought one. Where's the key at though? Oh, it's in there. And now here they come. Oh no, this is gonna be a nightmare. The one's down. Oh. we're going to use the big boy on this. Can it really not come in here? I might regret that later, but no point doing that, is there? Oh, melter! I forgot I had the melter. Alright, well, it helped it could come into the... That was good. I feel like I kind of cheesed that a little bit, because... But hey, I mean, if you can't go in there, I mean, what am I supposed to do? Walk out and get killed, I guess? Maybe. Maybe some would say that is what I'm supposed to do. Anyway. What's done is done. So... Maybe that'll mean that in this next fight, when I trigger this open again, maybe we're now going to see Ambles in the fight as well. I'm not sure. Just trying to find some ammo. For a few of the guns. But... It's interesting I haven't found a plasma rifle. Some of the stuff in this final chapter has been quite hidden, so I wouldn't be surprised if I did actually miss some weapons. What have I missed? Yeah, just the plasma gun. So I wouldn't be surprised if I managed to actually miss that. Because... What was it? The Vengeance launcher, or whatever it's called, was actually quite out of the way when I found that one in this chapter. Okay, so that's a bit of ammo for everything now, so we may as well trigger the next one. I can throw down a quick save there, and if it's overwhelming, like I expect it to be, almost like it should be, then we can always revert back. Trying to remember where to go though. So easy to get lost. At least it's quick to sort of zip around. Should have gone all the way here. Is this it? No. Yeah. Right. Well, I'll throw down an actual savey save. And let's do this. Please, Joyce. Makes sense. Considering how difficult some of the fights are. Oh, no, I'm playing one too. So, yeah. This is now super serious. That was just blasting. Ooh, that's a good shooting there, Tex. Let's go around and clear some of this other stuff up. So I'm not fighting everything that's shooting me in the butt. Getting how ineffectual . Okay, Vengeance launching good. Often I'd be worried that there's going to be continual spawning. Oh, look, some of these things move. Oh, wow. It's really hit me from anywhere, that. I need to find some. There's help everywhere. No reason. Wow. Yep. So I just run a quick save here. Some of the aids and stuff. We've got an asteroid. Oh my god. Okay, what other guns do we got here? I got a bunch of ammo back for the bandit sources, so... Quite good at clearing that. Not good for these though. Okay. Unless they're standing next to. Fuel canisters, or whatever you want to call them. Interesting how when I'm just running around, there's health and stuff. Return to entry airlock. Does that mean I can just leave? Man, Emperor, forgive me, but. Seriously considering it. No! We're going up there, apparently. Oh, this is bad news. All right. Throwing a handful of goo gravel. Man, just little things nudging me around. Delta? Oh, yeah. You're never going to get a moment's rest to find where he's supposed to go. Until you clear that unclean one. Melter, that one. I need to get close to him and then use this. Wow. They're just so accurate. And I mean, it's the only thing that makes the game have challenge, right? Oh, it's annoying. The unclean one needs to be killed. keep getting more things further. And even though it said that I could end the stage, I don't believe that's actually true. Wow. Took a lot of damage. Okay, let's throw a save down here. And let's see how much. I feel like that did quite a bit of damage. That was a bad crack grenade. Okay. Somehow getting worse. Is that stuff spawning in endlessly, or another broke run? Or is this just the fight to end all fights? So we just give it. Oh. As expected. Is that the super grenade? Jeez, that on down clean one. Fresh play toad. So let's just burn him down if I can. Yeah, okay. So I'm just going to throw a quick save in there because I feel as though I can survive this now quite easily. Now it is literally just a matter of just clearing up that CPI. Nice try, buddy. Flying leap. Okay, let's get some explosive stuff out. Not sure whether I did enough to completely knock him over. I feel like maybe yes. Out of bolts up. Trying to get some splash damage on them, so it's not a matter of having to shoot every single one independently. Some of them you just have to. This is really my fault for letting so many of them spawn while I got with that unclean one, because burning it down, honestly, wasn't that bad. I just sort of made it hard for myself. It appears. Could be a reason why he suddenly became easier to kill. But I'm not sure. Now, that's a matter of finding out of here. So, there was a big tower right in front of me. That's as much as I got going. So, okay. Is it container hanging way up in the air? I believe I was fairly far from. Oh, there it is. So it'll be over there somewhere. At least that's the first thing I remember when I came in. It could have been I walked around for a minute before I did that, but... Is it this? I assume? I think it'd be smart enough to lock those other doors. Maybe not. Oh no, okay. Love it. That works. Killed everything. Yes, I did. Out of necessity. Almost as long as the Escher puzzle stage from chapter 1. Coming directly to Greya. Kill the heretics controlling them before they can decimate the planet. Yes, sir. Gun deck loaded to gain control. Oh, the purging. Here I go purging again. It's gotta be easy to go straight away. Nerdlings. Now, where to? This is though there's another level up there. These are elevators, presumably, but... Ah, here we go. Warning, internal engine exhaust below. Safety features uninstalled to appease machine spirit. Do they even have a concept of safety features in the Imperium of Man? Can't imagine there was any sort of workers, hard-earned workers' revolution to get a weekend or work week. Hate lunch hour. Get that. Hard to dodge in here. Still getting hit. Vengeance bolt gun. Oh yeah. Why not? Big one. to it, I assume. Wow. Overwhelmed. That's what you want, the Vengeance and the Plasma, and there's... Okay. I'll try and stay... Am I crazy? Is the Plasma doing more damage? Than it was, or is it just because I was so used to killing everything with one shot? Good God. That when things started to take a couple of shots, it felt unrealistic. But yeah, you just need everything to be splashed down at the moment. More than one enemy is just about every shot, right? At this point. We've been there fishing with it. So I want to be really clear, this isn't me trying to tell other people how to play the game or how to suck eggs. If you got an effective way that you're doing it, like, just do it your way. It's more just internal monologue than what's working for me, right? So, it helps you. Awesome. Doesn't. It is good. Another big fight. Maybe when I hit the switch, right? Should I pick up the stuff first? It's crazy not to, right? Oh, that's cool. Yeah, no, I can really respect you having work and design and going to some of these later stages. Too many games, you know, especially these types of games, they expect people to play, you know, sort of get their money's worth out of the first couple of hours. Maybe they don't, you know, struggle through to the end. Always. So you often see the later stages can be a bit on the sparser side, just with really the difficulty and you know, that's fairly typical. This is quite different. This is clearly the superior mission set, in my opinion, to Chapter 2. So the struggle is getting through Chapter 2, in my opinion. And then you get this kind of crazy, almost turns into like an arena shooter, a horde mode arena shooter at the end here. Which is just crazy. But you've got, you know, that sort of hard-earned knowledge from doing your early missions. And some things that seem bad or seem hard to use, you know, when you were playing earlier, smashed myself with a plasma gun there, that wasn't really clever. become a lot easier to use. Get it. Hello. That guy with the stub was giving him 5 or 6 shots though. Alright. Put some ammo back up. Looks as though we've more or less dealt with this area. Which is a shame because I was having a lot of fun in there actually. Some big reactor thing. Elevator. Okay. Moving on. Throwing down another quick save here. Why not? I don't use them really enough, so gotta have some clips in there of me using it. There he is. Can't leave him behind. He'll get lonely. Battle these heretic buddies. Well, they just give you that tiny smattering of that grab gun ammo. I like it because it's like a... It's basically like the panic button, right? You can pull that out. Strange the mental sort of gymnastics you have to do to use a plasma gun against the little nurgling dudes, but it does work in the game. Gameplay wise, it makes sense. Because of the slash now. That's quite a few kills, apparently. Don't go. Death is honor, the station's mausoleum, the most hallowed Mechanicus remains from the crown's attendants. Interred here. Mechanicus remains from the crown's attendants are interred here. A grim forebear of what is to come if we do not halt this foul incursion. Right. Well, ouch. Sorry. Just banged my knee on part of my stupid desk there. Right on my knee's funny bone. Cogitating remembrances of crown heroes interred within the site. The word cogitating is outside of the 40k setting. Not a word you hear very often, huh? No. Okay, we need a yellow key card. Bolt at one another. Another yellow key card door. Not sure how efficient that was, but whatever. Felt good. Red keycard door, so I'm yellow and red. Not sure that we'll have more around. This seems to be the way now. All these missions. Okay, we've got a regular no keycard door, so. Oh, even bigger waste. They should have got a grenade themselves, though, right? Gee, I wonder if I should have just shot that. Ow. Okay, we got the red key card. So we're getting somewhere. Some ammo. So I do go back that way, but I just want to check to see if there's any ammo in here I can use. Okay, good stuff. Wait. This is a yellow door. So that actually isn't the way to go. Okay. I'll go back to there. Red door. Oh, it was this one. Well, got them the wrong way around. Space Marine over here. Got the heavy gold off. Interesting. Purple door there already. That was good. I knew exactly how they could get that guy. Unless it was just swinging at him, just checking up enemies in, but. Let's go! So I don't have the purple keycard yet. Moving up. Continuing up. Probably Vengeance would have been better there with them all tied in like that, or just Nugs, I guess. I don't remember where I picked up the purple keycard, it must have been there somewhere. That's interesting. So I do have the purple keycard now. It just seems like those regular flamers, just the regular old bolt gun, does a perfectly good job against them. These from over here. Okay. Okay. These little contempt nuggets and the yellow key card. Just bolt around though, but Green Sun succumbing to corruption. Readings from Crown indicate process can be reversed. So I don't think I want to come this way because that was the red door that went through and I got the purple key. So now I should. Now I've got the yellow key, I should start this one. Every time I change to a smaller gun to just deal with the regular middle town guys. That looks like a dude. Here. Yellow door over here. But I think, oh no, this is it. Well, it's getting me somewhere. New area. Okay, they're saying you want grab cannon, so I should just double check. Yeah. That's fine. Give me full ammo for everything. I'll take it. What? What am I doing? Stuff teleporting in. Really should save myself having to fight two new dudes. I'll still get hit. Ugh. That's a weird purge. Just that was really small for this side. Save the game. A little inconsistent, but I guess, you know, they got to keep guessing somehow. It can't just be, expect the ramp up. Full linear difficulty curve. You know, arguably is how you're supposed to do it, but... Don't fire that thing. Let's change the gun. It's bad, right? Guns. If you died there or if you teleported away, I assume you teleported away. Let's clear out some of this stuff. Yeah, he's still there. Oh, you bastard. Oh, that's below. There he goes. Some of that sweet contempt. I lost all mine. Yep. Definitely makes it easier when you have the grab gun. I can just leave. Let's check. I'll just see what's over here for anyone who's curious. A little bit of grab gun out. Didn't use my Volcraft gun for that one. Observing space, archiving position, archiving arrow, space. Right. Whatevs. Weird. Drink level's coming a bit, something. I wonder how close I am to the end now. The sorcerer has done something profane to the warp drive, and a beam of chaotic energy has been granted directly into the sun. Send the device and reach the sorcerer. Okay. Gela device operating. Purpose unknown. Well, if the Gela device is working, I'm having all these demons here. Interrupted energy reading. Rating extends alarm. Pursue the path of direct energy beam. Okay. So follow the direct energy beam. Go that way. I believe that's what it's saying. Oh. This shotgun got smashed twice. milk. I bent to Malin, and I did that instead. Hopefully there's some health around here, because I'm messing up. So that's the way to go. Yeah, I'm just going to go around and pick up the... He's flinching. Okay, use the bonus to launch on this guy. By myself, apparently. Something. This is not the path of the energy beam, so it's possible you go in there and there's just a locked door that needs a key card, so maybe this is not the way for the key card. Not sure that was worth that. But it looks cool. Sometimes you just have to chainsaw the chaos mines. It would be interesting to see a playthrough of this where someone just uses the Volta, right? The game being called Boltgun. And it still is the gun that feels the best in this game, even though it doesn't do enough damage in some situations. And it forces you to sort of switch to something else. Okay, with a red keycard, obviously. It'd be curious to see what that looks like. Is this where I came in? I don't think so. Attention, sliding mechanism poses severe danger. Yeah, fair enough. It's like that scene from is that film? The Star Trek knockoff film. It's not really a knockoff, it's a spoof, rather. Guys, when you get crushed by the thing. Going faster now? The worst is to put a toad in. Okay, just got a quick save here because I don't have to do that again. I'm sure the prize will go up for this, I think. Yeah, so if you're thinking plasma, like it operates in Darktide, or if you played Darktide and used the plasma, then it's going to mess you up for the plasma gun in this game. Because the plasma gun in this game, what it actually is a rocket launcher. Functions. You're going to fire it down and use the splash damage to hit as many enemies as you can in a group. Okay, red door. Where did I see that? Over here. Jeez. I'm curious to know what I missed out on in the first room. I didn't follow the hallway that went up to the conveyor. Plasma rifle in Darktide works more like... It does like collateral hits where you shoot through multiple enemies in a line. Because it like over penetrates everything, so it's a very different sort of understanding of what a plasma rifle does. Playing with the one in this game. And you sort of once you've worked that out, actually quite good. Okay, now we got that big boy. Should have this is really the right gun for this, but I haven't found anything that's particularly useful against these big toads, apart from the gravity gun, obviously, so. Okay, I've used all my splash damage. Yeah, those small frogs are really the only thing that the shotgun is good for, apart from the regular marines and stuff at close range. Obviously it's, I guess, the little jumpy dudes as well, but you're better off just dumping the plasma shot in the middle of them, in my opinion. Alright, where to now? Maybe the melter. I keep forgetting that exists. I should use that against the big frogs. It's quite nice to have, you know, I don't know whether other people play these sorts of games like this, but it's nice to have a gun that I use for a particular enemy. Because it makes me sort of still use each gun, but conserve them for the situations where they're the most effective. So maybe big frogs and ambles use the melter. Because the Volkite thing, as good as this is, it takes a long time and a lot of ammo to kill the big frogs with this. What's this? This is really good for those aspiring Chaos Marines because it gives them, it doesn't allow them to, doesn't allow them to come back as a Chosen. Plasma sort of does that too. It takes longer, and when they get in close, you can splash damage to yourself or hurt yourself with that. I've got all the grab ammo apparently, so save that for something big. Frog out. Oh, it's one of those dudes. I'm trying to think what this gun... I said in one of the earlier videos that it reminds me of the... needle rifle from Halo. which it still does. I don't know why I keep pulling it out. I thought of an even better one. In Mass Effect, there's a pistol that fires little direct fire sticky grenade things. And it kind of works like that. There's another bloke running around somewhere, apparently. Other side. Heavy balls to make shit right of these things. All flying enemies, really. I don't know how it's still full. After I just shot that thing, but whatever. Yeah, this is repeating. So am I going around in circles? Probably. No. 10 minute waste observed. Recommend course of action, avoid contact. Yeah, okay, so I've been through here. Yep, following the arrows. Oh, interesting. I think I jumped fast enough not to take any damage there. Okay, so the elevator took me down. And then I just sort of went round again, so... Why? What am I doing? Yeah. Wasn't really expecting that to do anything, but still. I still just have the red key. Observing correctly. Ah, yeah, okay. I don't know how I missed that Volkite ammo. I do want that. So, what was I using for that? No, it's not. Stood on some of the green goobers, which sometimes seem to do damage. Okay, splash damage. It's good. Plasma ammo, thank you very much. Warcraft ammo, that's good news. Bolt by bolt. Yeah, that's a bit of killing for a regular dude. I just going to throw a save here because I meant to do one before I hit the jump pad, but I think I got too close to it and it launched me up. Throwing champion, okay. Going out the beam. News, shotgun for you. It's getting very mechanical now, the combat, but you know, that's not the game's fault, that's just the way I'm choosing to play it. Absolutely, play it however it feels fun to you, I reckon. Gravity gun. Yeah, because that also beams all the little shitty goobers that come out of it too. Yeah, that's the way to do that. Save a full gravity gun. And it'll splat all the little nerglings that come out of it. Favorite. Yeah, I mean, it's expensive on ammo, but it seems to be the most effective. Gotta use it on something. Alright. Now where to? Why I decided to shoot that, just felt right in the moment. What's that gun? Oh. Yeah, just that green goober. Very religious symbolism. I almost said symbology there. Like I have become the meme, the can't English meme. Okay, some cogs. I am legitimately going around in circles here. So, oh, there's a jetpack. What are you looking at? No? I thought I saw a jetpack thing around. That's good news. That's exactly what I needed. Something blue over there. Let's have a look. Oh, I think I could just see that. See that across the map. That was a bit weird. It was the draw distance. Maybe. I don't know why I'm going back in here, because it just feels as though this is just a big loop, but maybe there's a door out that I've missed. So. Nope. There are, like, Wolfenstein and Doom style secrets, but I've only found a couple. I'm sure there's some really good ones. Some places that really turn some encounters on their heads. But I'm not gonna, I mean, I've been trying not to just spend ages searching for cool, you know, secrets in this playthrough, so I won't do that. I was just looking for a regular door, but I feel as though it's not out here. So I have to do my, my thing again where we just search. Okay, what's it showing me? We've got a cross, we've got the beamy boys. The guy at the start of the mission did say, when in doubt, follow the beams. So all the beams are converging at that point there. There are special guns and stuff on platforms that I can't easily get to. There's a thing that looks like it's a special thing. There's a jump pad there, which is what brought me up. There's a platform here I don't believe I've been to. But I'm unsure how you would get up there. This is where the Great Unclean One became the Great Dismembered One. Oh, that shit hurts. I was wondering if it would. Makes sense. Oh, that was the green goober. Hey, what you looking at? Ammo. It's like, pick up the ammo, bro. Yes, that's really helpful. Thank you. Do I drop back down? I don't know why I'd do that. What is that? What benefit does that give me? Because I had to have come up here for a reason. I mean, maybe. Because the boss was up here. I will find something. Very strange. This takes me up. Oh! Okay, found it. Champion. Okay. This isn't like the shaft in Quake 3, you know? I was kind of expecting to have like a maximum range. It doesn't seem to. If it does, it's a lot longer than you think. I like that. So I'll save down here. It's nice being just to wait for me to come up here and then not shoot back at the wall. Alright, that's the end of that stage. I'd say a good 5 minutes of that was just me trying to find that jump point. Because I'm good. Your crusade draws to a close. The final battle is at hand. Heretics and demons pollute the command decks. Eliminate the sorcerer, reclaim the fragment, and put an end to this heresy. Well, here we go, guys. This appears to be the final mission. Attention, says the servitor. Yeah? Sorry, I thought when you said attention, you were trying to tell me something, or... Source fragment located. Psyker location identified. Engaged combat rituals. The Emperor protects. I have identified ammunition. Well, thank you so much. I'm full of ammunition, but thank you, Mr. Servitor. I'll call you Bob. Ooh, that was a very clever. Door. other door. Get the guns if you somehow miss them. I don't feel like it. Well, I've got quite a bit of ammo for this thing. The BFG. Prepare armament for final confrontation. Well, I don't feel like it would be just as easy as me going out into the gravity gun and blasting straight away. As much fun as that would be. I'm sure there's more to it than that, so I'll keep using my weapons as I okay, don't fall down the hole there. It's nice that that doesn't count as a game over though. I don't know why, because every other death is like, no, reload a save, bro, but so what does that give me? Max content. That's good news. Okay. Plasma rifle. For the little boys. Lots of bosses going on at once here. That makes sense, I suppose. So I guess I should just blast him. These frogs will mess you up. Infinite ammo. Does that include this? Well, that's good, please. Out of it. Just clean everything up. I'm trying not to die. Apparently it's... Yeah, just use it against the little dudes. Why not? What am I doing? Shoot the dudes. Well, you're nearly dead. Okay. At least got rid of the great end thing now that I can cleanse it. Oh, heaven's gonna throw in a quick save there because I'm cheap like that. I can't use the gravity gun on one noble. This is a boomer shooter, so it comes with that need for frugality. So it comes very too hard, I'm not even sure that's a grab at the moment. Sort of punishment for wasting things is the order of the day. Hey, tiny little bug. Let's go fight this dude a bit. that Tobias, Tumulus. What kind of a name is Tumulus? Where is he? Oh, this is I'm gonna fall. What? I'm gonna land on something. Apparently you can run up there. That was good. This could have very easily not have been the case. That doesn't do any of the enough damage. Have you built a movie? You don't want to be too far away. Maybe the melter. Loves the vengeance. Doesn't even have a health bar. That's probably because I'm not shooting at him. He's gone. Oh, falling down the hole again. Very forgiving hole. Got like this super beam thing, but oh, that thing there that I'm spending too long paying attention to the flying enemies to avoid. Another cheeky little quick save there. A little bit more gravity gun. Ammo? What have I got much? Body. Not much. I'll use it though. First thing he does is teleport and make you waste some of it. Get on him. Oh, we're getting melter? Yeah. Oh yeah, that is not good. Quick save again. Vengeance launcher. So I'm assuming he's going to... I don't know what he's going to do. So it's going to be a few of the main bosses. And every time you kill him, you're probably going to have to fight another one of them. Get some health and stuff. know. I've forgotten what I use for these things. Let's grab it again. This seems to be doing the trick anyway. A lot of bullets. Oh, hello. Now what are we fighting? Relaying traitor Psyker Boxcom very well. I didn't get a chance to read that while I was fighting for my life. I don't know how that works. Hey! How's it going, Kurt? Appreciate you stopping by, dude. Yeah, no, this is the final fight, I believe. Oh, I'm just run out of all everything. He's got a shield on, so I guess it's just the big old blade toad. Appreciate you coming into lurk though, dude. Hope your dinner with your mum was good. Oh god. I'm gonna get down there and kill that bomb toad. Get out of there. Some gravity ammo. Oh, jump. Oh, I missed it. Good. Oh, well. I haven't even seen these. Okay. Got quite a bit of gravity ammo now. Oh, he's still got his. Hold up. Thank you. fixed his wagon at least. Oh, way too low health. Right. Stood in it there for a while, apparently. Nearly got me, you little bastard. But is there health? Yes, there is. Okay. Making my way back up. Gotta get back to the ammo. Oh, it's a bolt right ammo. Good stuff. But where is he now? Probably chasing me down somewhere. Yeah, this stuff's respawning. That's, I mean, obviously. Ah, I'm wondering where that thing was if it's raining. Damage down on me. Oh, he's up. Horrible janky piece. Busting me up. So whenever there's an enemy that gets close to him now, he gets the shield from them. But I think I've taken everything out. Fairly easy to dodge now, to be honest. We're gonna run out of bolts or ammo fairly quickly. Have a grenade. Just disappeared somewhere. Fair enough too, I was crunching through him there. There he is. Feels appropriate to kill him with like the regular bolter, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to. Preferably not the shotgun. Oh yeah, I got too close and he starts doing that insta-hit beam. But at this range, oh, killed him. Woo!
Excellent work. With the sorcerer defeated and the Mechanicus device destroyed, we bought Grya time. Now give me the fragment. It must be contained. Without this to power the device, the warp rift will begin to close itself. But this isn't over. The scars of chaos run deep. Who knows what foul entities live here and on Grya? There are still heretics to purge. Ready your weapon.
Cool.
Well, I have to say, if you have any interest in 40k or FPS games, to be perfectly honest, especially at the lower price point, yeah, you should definitely play this. Even if you just want to play the first chapter to, you know, just have fun, just sort of smashing everything, for sure. It does get a little tiring, as most of these games do, because they're just bullet hell, you know, just constant input. Especially, like, just shooting that, like, the last boss there over and over again, with very simple to dodge sort of attack mechanics, once you've cleared out all the ads. Yeah. I don't know how much fun that is. It's more like you're just sort of going through the struggle to sort of finish it off. But there's really good parts of this game. Most of the first chapter, as well as the majority of the third chapter, are super cool. The only part of the last chapter I didn't really care for was that last battle, because it was just tiring and kind of boring. But boring's a bit rough. It's just you know, everything, it's such a bullet sponge, that type of boss. And you're fighting bosses you've already fought from earlier in the game, which is fine, you know, because the mechanics all work. There's nothing wrong with that. It's just, you know. But then again, the boss in a 40k game has to be, you know, tough. So, but apart from that, yeah, there's tons of fun to be had there. So, especially if you can grab it on, you know, I'm sure at certain points this will come out. You know, when there's a new 40k game coming out, this will probably come out 50% off or something. And totally, if you're going to play for 2 or 3 hours for $10 or whatever, go nuts. You're going to play the whole thing? Sure. You know? Hope you guys enjoyed. I'm going to call that the end for today and this week. I got some plans in the future for, I'm going to play the Metro series, I think. I'm just deciding on what sort of format that's going to take. I'm a big FPS guy, but that's just games that I haven't played yet. For whatever reason, they've always been on the back burner. So I'd like to play through that trilogy. Whether that's the next thing I play or not, I'm not 100% sure. That's not blaming. Well, hope everyone enjoyed. Have a good one.